Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, the planet Neptune is the next one in the parade of planets that we have because as this year went through, we had Mercury, Venus, Jupiter, Saturn, Mars, and Saturn and Mars are still right here. But we don't see where Neptune is because Neptune is at magnitude about 7.9, so close to 8. And in order to bring that up, we go to our view window. And if you click on the SSO, Solar System Objects tab, click on the labels and markers, and then bring this slider all the way over, Neptune then pops up. I like to bring up the planet markers too. That way it's a little easier to know exactly where the planet's at. And I have the azimuthal grid up because I want to show you how high Neptune is right now. Actually, if we bring up one more marking on here, we're going to go to the markings tab and click on ecliptic of date because Neptune is actually pretty high up right now. And this is, mid October around 8 o'clock in the evening from 40 degrees north latitude. You may need to adjust that depending on your own latitude. But you can see that Neptune will actually be visible because it reached opposition about 5 weeks ago. So it's well placed right now to be able to see it for actually quite a good long while. If we skip ahead into November this time, Neptune is at 40 degrees. If we go over towards middle of December, it's still pretty high up at about 30 degrees. And actually, if we back up even an hour there, it's higher than 35 degrees. So that's nice and high. And then even into January, it looks like it's sunk over to 20 degrees. But if we actually back up to about 6 o'clock in the evening, so very early in the evening, not long after the sun's gone down, Neptune is still 30 degrees up. So let's go back to 8 o'clock here in the middle of October, and we're going to zoom in on where Neptune is at, and we will center where Neptune is because, as you can see, it's kind of in the middle of nowhere. There are not a lot of stars there. Some of these stars are like fourth magnitude stars. So if you have any light pollution, yeah, good luck. So here's how I'm going to show you to find it when you can't see anything. So if we bring up our sky and go to the labels and markers slider, we're going to bring up just a few of the brightest stars. Turn that off and get it out of the way for the moment. This star right here is part of the Great Square of Pegasus. So if we bring up our constellation lines, we can see how this is kind of where the neck of the flying horses, right where the wing would be, and then this is the head going out in Pegasus. And then Fomalhaut, which is a nice bright first magnitude star. It's really about the only bright thing there towards the southeastern sky. Neptune is very conveniently halfway in between those. So if we have our measuring tool on and go from Fomalhaut all the way over to where Markab is at, you can see it's about 45 degrees. And if we take half that distance, we're going to look at 22 degrees, go right to Neptune. Oh, look at that, 22 degrees. There's Neptune, exactly halfway. We're going to center Neptune, zoom way in, and you can see how close Neptune is to that line. I mean, it's right there. So if you can split that distance visually, you're going to do really well. Neptune's in Aquarius. Aquarius has largely a lot of dim stars. Most of the brighter ones are up in here, Saddle Malik and Saddle Sud. If we zoom in though, these are some of the stars that we want to be looking for. You see these little stars right here, Omega 1, Omega 2, this is Omega 3, Aquarii. Those are you're going to look for. You're going to look for this star, Chi Aquarii, this one, which I believe is Upsilon Aquarii, and then Lambda Aquarii over here. So when you find the hook here, you're going to want to look for these two stars because this is 4.2 magnitude and this is 3.7. So pretty close in brightness, and Neptune is almost right in between those. I have found Neptune with binoculars. Not too difficult to do from dark enough skies. You do need to use at least 7 by 35, 8 by 42, if you know what you're looking for. So ideally 7 by 50s, 10 by 50s, and then zoom in on this area. We can see how a 5 to 7 degree field of view would capture all of those. You'd be able to see these two stars and even some of these, if you had a circle there with Neptune in the middle. And you'll notice in the middle, there's also these two stars. Now, the way that I figured out exactly where I was looking at, because I did get confused a couple times, I had to keep going back to my map. If we click off all these star designations, so we don't have anything that's actually telling us where we should be, just we know where Neptune is. Here's what you want to do. See these three stars, look for that, this, and this. Those will be obvious. You'll be able to see that. That hook is going to be very apparent. So when you found that, you're going to look this way for that distance. That's again going to kind of be in a finder scope field of view or a binocular field of view. Look for these two stars in the middle. Now, here's how to not get confused, especially in a finder scope where everything is reversed left to right and upside down. Look for this star right there. And you're going to look at this and these. And it's not a great parallelogram, but it's close enough because you're not going to see that on this side. You are going to see it over on this side. Okay? So when you go here, look for this, look for these two in the middle, and you'll know that Neptune is down and below. And then with a telescope, you can then zoom in. And I actually had a really close view of this when I was looking at things the other day. This is about the magnification that I was looking at, about around 120 times or so. I did not quite see all these stars. Mostly what I could see was Neptune, because this star is 11th magnitude. This star is almost 11th magnitude. That's 11th magnitude. This one's even dimmer. That's a 13th magnitude star. I couldn't see that with my 10-inch telescope. So Neptune should pop out if you have enough magnification on it and you have a large enough aperture. Although at eighth magnitude, you can get 120 times on that, even with a 60 millimeter refractor. You're not going to be able to push it more than that. But 120 times, if your atmosphere is steady, shouldn't be too much of an issue. You will not see a disk or much of a disk. You might see a hint of a disk because this apparent diameter, 2.35 arc seconds. That's going to be hard to see. So, how do you know for sure that you're looking at Neptune and not a star? Neptune looks a little different than a star. It's not quite as brilliant as what a star would do. And in addition to that, the color blue that Neptune is a little deeper than most any blue-white star that you see. So, O and B class stars don't really look like Neptune does. Neptune's a little deeper. It's got a more bluish blue to it rather than kind of a blue white like the stars are. So look for Neptune. That light takes a long time to get to us. At 29 astronomical units, that's a long way off. If I remember correctly, it's about 4 hours, 4 light hours away. So long distance. However, it's visible in binoculars, in a small telescope, and you can find it. All you have to do is look halfway in between which two stars? Fomalhaut, Markab up in Pegasus, boom, right there. Find the little hook here of the Omega stars and these three ones. Find your parallelogram, and Neptune is right there. And it will not move a whole lot over the next several months. So if I go ahead in time, you can see it doesn't move much relative to those stars. It goes over there. See, there's your parallelogram there and up here. So then it's just kind of right below it. But then I'm going to go back to like 6 o'clock in the evening. You can see how it'll come back. Oh, and see, Mars even goes by it right there in early December. Boom. Second, 6th and 7th of December, Mars will be right there. You can find Neptune really easily then. Although it might be so brilliant, it'll kind of block it out. But for a week or so there, you can find it easily because of Mars. Once Mars is out of the way, you can see how it just sort of spins right back to where it was before as we were looking at it right now. So lots of months. You got easily 3, 4 months to be able to see this planet. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.